Treyarch was like, oh, you're complaining about how bad this is? Let's buff the crap out of it. Now you can complain about how good it is when you keep dying by it. And welcome back, guys. So Black Ops Cold War got a new update today. We're not going to go over all the patch notes because honestly, everything was really minor. The only major thing they changed is they buffed the shovel slash the E-tool in multiplayer. And if you guys have used this pre-patch, you know this was the single worst weapon in the game. By far the hardest weapon to grind gold in the game. If you guys got the Sigma gold, just imagine that, but three or four times harder. This thing was bad. They updated it today, and boy, did this gun take a, I call it gun. This shovel, this, you know, melee weapon, I keep calling it a freaking gun, completely did a 180. Went from being, you know, the single worst weapon in the game to honestly a top tier weapon and hands down the best melee weapon in the entire game. The knife, get rid of it. Everything else, get rid of it. This is better than the katana. This is better in every aspect. Everything this weapon does is better than every other melee weapon in the entire game, boys. So it's huge. Not only did they make it a one-hit killing core, as you can see, we're playing core right now, one-hitting these guys. They made it swing quicker, and now you run quicker with it. All three of those things, which if you use this weapon pre the update, you know the only reason this thing was bad was because the fact that it took two hits to kill. And them changing that alone would have made it the best weapon. But not only did they change that, they made you run a little bit quicker with it, and they made it swing even quicker, which is just like, Treyarch was like, oh, you're complaining about how bad this is? Let's buff the crap out of it. Now you can complain about how good it is when you keep dying by it. Oh, look at 7 kill streak. 7 kill streak with the freaking shovel. Is this about to be, did we get 8? Yep, 8 kill streak. Pre this update, you would have never been able to get an 8 kill streak with a shovel, even in like the lowest tier of lobbies. That would have been insane. And this was just our first game on, casual, quick game, boom, 8 kills, like it's nothing. Bang, bang, bang. Come on, one more, one more, one more, one more. Ow, oh, hey, Mark, no, don't worry, we'll pop the shovel. Whoop, whoop, so yeah, all right, we're back, boys, another game here. If you grinded this DM Ultra before the buff, can we get a rip in chat? I know very few people were dumb enough to grind this because everyone kind of knew a buff was waiting around the corner, but I wanted to test myself. I wanted to pull my hair out. I wanted to do something ridiculous, and we did actually grind a DM Ultra before the update, but it's ridiculous. This went from being the single hardest weapon in the entire game to grind gold to being one of the easiest because of how ridiculous this thing is now. We were in bottom tier SBMM lobbies, struggling to use this in hardcore. Now, honestly, we're in high-end SBMM lobbies, just frying with this thing. Like, it's just running, knifing, like it's nothing, just casually playing. Just, it's so easy to use. It went from complete 180, like I was saying. This weapon went from being absolute trash to being kind of like a top-tier weapon. This is definitely the best knife by a mile. Like I was saying, there's not a single thing that another melee weapon does that this weapon doesn't do better. It's better in every statistical thing than every other knife weapon in the game, which to me is like, that's not really balanced because, you know, different knife weapons, they all do, people say that they're all skins and they don't do different things. That's not true. There are differences. It's just usually they put all of the good stats on the some weapons and all of the bad stats on one, like the hammer and the machete have all of the worst knife stats. Like everything you don't want about a knife, you have on there. They're slow. They have that very large amount of range, adding that lunge, making it super inaccurate. And they're slower. And it's, I don't know if they're slower or not, but they feel slower just because of how slow you swing with them. So all of that stuff is just worse. And whereas the katana and this have very little range, which is what you want. So it's not going to have that inaccurate lunge. And you're going to be able to swipe faster. And it's just like, why? What's the balance there? Why would you give all of like, why would you give all of the good stats to like two weapons and then all of the bad stats to the other weapons? It's just, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me, but hey, DM Ultra Shovel, definitely the best looking DM Ultra melee weapon out there. Out of all of the ones that have, you know, camos on them, the shovel's by far the best looking. The coverage of this thing is insanely good, and it is now going to be accessible way more easily by so many more people. If you didn't get this DM Ultra before because you're like, dude, I'm not grinding that, I'm not crazy, you can easily now get the shovel, grind it gold. It's only going to take like maybe 2 hours now. It took us 5 hours to get this bad boy gold, and it should now only take you about a fraction of time with that. But yeah, with that, boys, we're going to go ahead and wrap this up. Just a real short one. Just want to let you know that the shovel now is actually quite insane. Actually, I want to go see at the end of this game, I want to see what my KD stats are for each and every melee weapon. I feel like the katana is probably the best, and the shovel, unfortunately, is going to be the worst, but it is only the worst because, you know, we grinded it DM Ultra back when it was, like, the worst weapon in the game. So after this game, I'll show you guys all of the stats that I have with all of the knife weapons in the game, and we'll see kind of the difference between the hammer, machete, katana, and then I wonder how much lower, just how much lower the E-tool is in those other two, because, you know, oh man, the grind for this thing. All right, boys, now we're at the end of the game. I'm honestly scared to see kind of the stats with these weapons. So the sledgehammer and machete, which are by far the single two worst knife weapons in the game. We've got a 0.79 for both of these weapons here. And we did unlock DM Ultra for every single one of these, so it kind of gives you a perspective. And then for the regular knife, we've got a 0.76, which this one is a little bit lower than the sledgehammer machete. The knife is actually better. The reason this is lower probably is because this was before Nuketown was added. We grinded this gold back when the game first came out. There wasn't any sort of Nuketown. They're all bigger maps. So obviously we're at more of a disadvantage while we were using this. Whereas obviously with the machete and the sledgehammer, we had options like Nuketown 24/7. So, and then obviously the katana, which as you can see, a little bit of a higher KD with that one. And now we look at the E-tool with the 0.43. And this is after playing a couple games, actually doing really, really positive games with it. I think we had a 3 to a 2 KD both games we used with this. And now we're rocking a 0.43 because of, the KD for this will never be fixed. We will always have a massively negative KD because we got about 400 kills with this while grinding at gold and just, oh man. I like how it says engagement ranges aren't tracked on melee weapons. I wonder why they're not tracked. All right, boys, now real quick, we're gonna go over the rest of the patch notes. So we got obviously the E-tool changes here. Besides that, we just got some changes to different modes. We got stockpile, eliminate enemies to pick up tags. We don't know what that is. We got knife fight 3v3, which sounds pretty fun. 3v3 gunfight with rotating randomized loadouts featuring blueprint versions of the machete, the katana, sledgehammer, e-tool, and knife. So pretty cool, but it sounds like you're going to be getting randomized knife weapons, which to me sounds really unfair because if your whole team gets like hammers and their whole team gets like, you know, katanas and e-tools, you don't stand a chance because the knife weapons are so crazily imbalanced that depending on what weapon you have, it's going to be really hard to beat the other player, even if they're way higher skill than, or even if they're way lower skill than you. And even me having like a pretty low skill at the game, I feel like if you give me the E-tool and you give like a pro player the sledgehammer, I think I win that engagement the majority of the time, just because it's not a fair fight. The E-tool is 1,000 times better than the sledgehammer. So sounds fun. Sounds a little rage inducing because I know my luck. I'm going to spawn at a 3v3 gunfight. It's going to be, oh, machete, sledgehammer, machete, sledgehammer. I'm never going to be the one with the E-tool or the katana. I'm always going to be getting the slow, inaccurate, big weapons. Other than that, they added a new combined arms mosh pit, which cool, stuff like that. But besides that, I mean, it was really just the new playlist. If we go here down to zombies, as you can see, nothing new, nothing cool for zombies, so I didn't really cover it too much. That's why I'm putting it here at the end of the video instead of starting off with it, because I know not everyone watches the end of the video, and this was kind of just, you know, for people interested, here's what they changed. The new knife fight sounds pretty cool, but besides that, nothing really notable else about these patch notes, boys. But yeah, with that, boys, I'm going to go ahead and leave you here. Are you guys going to go and grind this DM Ultra now? It's definitely something I recommend you get for zombies and multiplayer, because it's best in class for both of them, so you definitely want to have this as a tool. If you ever plan on using a knife weapon in either game mode, 100%, no matter what you're doing, the shovel is what you want to use. There is not a better one that does anything else better at anything than what the shovel does. I can't believe they completely just turned this around from being the worst weapon to, you know, being the best with one little switch. But hey, it's Treyarch. They can do whatever they want. But that's it, boys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time.